Hello, everyone, and welcome to the 3X Value Growth Podcast. My name is Carrie Sauls. I'm a value growth advisor to the middle market and author of the book, Multiply Your Business Value in 3 Steps. I come to you, as always, from New Hampshire, and because of that, I start with a piece of New Hampshire trivia. And today's piece of trivia has to do with the poem we all learned before we even went to school, Mary Had a Little Lamb. Well, the author is Sarah Josepha Hale. She was an author and journalist in Newport, New Hampshire, and she wrote the poem Mary Had a Little Lamb in 1830. So that's my trivia about New Hampshire. Today, I am joined by Kristen Gallagher. Welcome, Kristen.
Hi, Carrie. Thank you so much for having me.
It's a pleasure to have you. Where are you calling in from today?
Today, I'm actually calling in from Santa Fe, New Mexico. I'm on my annual business planning strategy retreat, but normally I'm based in Portland, Oregon.
Oh, big difference.
Yes.
Well, thank you again, Kristen, for joining us. It's a real pleasure to have you. For people who don't know Kristen, let me give you a little bit about her background. Kristen Gallagher is an organizational strategy and learning designer. She's the founder and CEO of Edify, a consultancy that builds technical onboarding programs for high-growth teams. She brings over a decade of management organizational development to Edify. She has architected and delivered onboarding programs for companies ranging in growth from 1 to over 100 people per quarter, in just one office to over 13 global offices, and for fully on-site to fully remote teams. What a range. Gallagher frequently speaks and writes on the topics of onboarding, change management, and team communication. Welcome again, Kristen Gallagher.
Thank you so much, Carrie.
Well, our title for today's 7-question interview is Adding Value with Onboarding. Kristen, are you ready to do that in 7 minutes?
I'm ready. I'll be brief.
Number one, who is your ideal client?
So my ideal client is a team usually led by a technical team leader, a vice president of engineering or so, director of engineering, at a mid-size technology or tech-enabled company.
And for those tech companies, what problem are you solving for these businesses?
We help them increase their retention of new hires and decrease their attrition and also increase their time to productivity so that people get ramped up faster for their technical new hires.
That's huge, definitely. My third question, what are the typical symptoms of that problem that you see business owners experiencing or that they're talking about?
I think the biggest problem that people talk about is the pain with onboarding. So it's really challenging for managers who are managing a variety of people and a variety of projects to bring on people quickly and to actually share the right kind of knowledge the right way. And it's really painful for the existing team to basically have to onboard that person without a plan. And it takes a lot of time for the new hire, so that new hire is also experiencing a lot of frustration.
Absolutely. Not a good way for somebody to start with your company.
No, not at all.
So with the fourth question then, what are the most common mistakes that you see them making when they try to solve this on their own?
I see people try to lean on a very basic checklist, or I see people try to lean on HR corporate onboarding. And the problem that we solve is very specific to the departmental and the team or the technical layer of a person's job. So you may get company onboarding, but you also need department and team onboarding that's specific to your job. And so the mistake I see the most is when people believe that they have a corporate onboarding program that will solve all of those problems for them. Or they just rely on a really basic checklist of here's the people you should meet, here are the things you should read. That's just not enough.
That's a huge gap that they're not covering, and they just assume that it's going to happen by osmosis, definitely. So my fifth question is, in this situation, what's one valuable action you can recommend to our audience listeners that they can implement that actually will help them increase this onboarding, which is adding value directly to the company?
Exactly. So I think the most valuable action and probably the easiest is the very next time that you have a new hire joining your company, you actually ask them to pay attention to what's missing and have them create a list of what kinds of information and knowledge they needed or wish that they had to make their onboarding better. And then you use that new hire to write that documentation or to gather that from subject matter experts.
That's so simple, and yet it's so doable, definitely. So the sixth question, building on that, what's one valuable free resource that you can direct people to that actually will help them even further in solving that problem?
Yeah, so I write a lot on Medium, and if you go to medium.com and find Kristen Maeve, that's K-R-I-S-T-N-M-A-E-V-E, you'll find a blog post that I wrote called MVP Onboarding for the 97% of Startups Who Have None. And in there, I know it's quite a lot of people who don't, or organizations that don't have onboarding. In there, there is a link to a free onboarding plan that you can make a copy of. It's a Google document. You can make a copy of it and use it as much as you like.
That's gold. Thank you. That's a great resource. So with all your years of experience, what's one question that I should have asked you that I didn't, that would add great value for our listeners? And please provide the answer.
Yeah, I think probably the question that I always wish I would get asked is, how do I help my managers onboard better? And the reason I think that that's the most important question in onboarding actually is that if a manager isn't onboarded well, then they're not going to be able to onboard the rest of their team well, and they're not going to be able to manage their team well. And the answer to that question, how should I manage the onboarding of my own managers better, is by going around to the rest of the managers in your company, similar with the tip I offered with new hires, figuring out what they needed when they got started, making that checklist for yourself. And then as you think about the kinds of tacit knowledge, the things that are in your head as a business owner, what kinds of things does the manager not know that you know about the ropes, say learning the ropes part, and write those things into the checklist as well. So I think that's a really important question and a pretty easy answer as well.
It's straightforward. It's just a matter of go back and do that with those people. Terrific. Very terrific. Thank you so much, Kristen Gallagher, for giving me this interview for the 3X Value Growth Podcast. Thank you for your time today.
You're so welcome. Thank you.
Thanks for checking out the 3X Value Growth Podcast. If you like what we're doing here, head over to iTunes and subscribe, leave us a review, or rate us. It's very much appreciated. And if you'd like to learn more about the 3X Value Growth Model, go to www.3xvaluegrowth.com/model for the PDF.